Greetings, everyone. This is Michael, and welcome back to a month of horror. That's right. Still celebrating horror films all the month of October. Well, guys, we're on to the next film now, and that film is none other than 1984's C.H.U.D. C.H.U.D. Sounds like maybe cow crap or something. A C.H.U.D. But anyway, this film, like I said, came out in 1984, and this is the special collector's DVD of the film. It has not been released to Blu-ray yet, and it's a damn shame because it definitely should be. C.H.U.D.'s one of those movies that I saw many, many years ago on, I believe it was home box office. But here's the disc itself, guys. It slides out of this. And what I like about it is, although it uses the same cover, it's least colorized a different way, and you see more of the scene itself. But there's the disc itself. And we'll open it up. No booklet included, but there's a DVD. Now, originally, when this film was released, it was excised in the editor's room because it was considered too grotesque. And originally, the running time for the theatrical cut for the film was 88 minutes. But on this special cut here, the film is actually 96 minutes long, so they reinserted a lot of the missing material, and that's, you know, cutting down a movie from 88 minutes to 96, that's quite a bit of material excised out. But C.H.U.D., guys, is a story of homeless people that go missing in the city of New York, and at first it's kind of ignored, you know, it's homeless people and nobody really cares. Now, the film stars John Heard as George Cooper. He's a photographer in the story, and his girlfriend is played by Kim Greist, or maybe Greist, and her name is Lauren Daniels in the film. Then we have Daniel Stern as AJ, the Reverend Shepherd, who runs a homeless shelter. And finally, rounding out the cast, we have Christopher Curry, who plays Captain Bosch, the head of the local police authorities. And in this movie, guys, the homeless people, like I said, start disappearing. And the police are aware of it, but they're really not doing too much about it. They figure, you know, it's just homeless people and, you know, these things happen. And some of the homeless people have taken to living underground for shelter in some of the sewers. And Daniel Stern, who plays the Reverend in the story, the head of the homeless shelter, gets a visit from Captain Bosch. And Bosch is questioning him about missing homeless people. And right away, the Reverend is kind of bewildered, thinking, why are you coming down here? Why is the chief of police handling this investigation? So he questions Bosch, and Bosch finally reveals that his wife was also one of the people that were missing. So a lot of homeless people come up missing, and the investigation continues into trying to find out just why they're disappearing. And in the meantime, John Heard's character, the photographer, is on an assignment to take pictures of the homeless people. He works for a magazine, and they're doing a story on homeless people, and he's the photographer. He's assigned to take pictures, so he kind of gets involved into the case because he also knows the Reverend, so he kind of goes to the homeless shelter, questions him, and he even has some intimate relationships, not intimate as sexual, but close relationships with some of the homeless people that are living underground. And Bosch continues in his investigation, and he kind of stumbles on the fact, with the help of the Reverend, that these homeless people are not only missing, but they're being preyed upon by someone or something. They're having bites taken out of them. Even the people in his own shelter come up vanishing, and they finally go down to the sewer system, and they gather some information, and they approach the a government agency that has done some work down there in the past. And I'm trying to be as vague as possible, guys, because a lot of you have probably never seen C.H.U.D., which stands for Cannibalistic Human Underground Dwellers, and I don't want to ruin the film for you. But Captain Bosch and the Reverend go to a committee, and they present their evidence, which they suspect people or some kind of creature is underneath in the sewers. So they present their evidence, and the committee pretty much just laughs them off and pretty much calls them ridiculous and monsters, come on. But they're closer than what they think. There are creatures in the subway system. Now, I could go a little bit further, but if I do, guys, it would possibly ruin the story for you or reveal too much, and I don't want to do that. But like I said, CHUD is one of those, I like to call one of those gems of a film that has been overlooked. It's achieved a cult following, but a lot of people don't know of this film or never seen it. It's kind of a story that, you know, one of those kind of thoughtful horror films that kind of blends true life events into a film, and it's kind of got a little bit to say about the homeless, about how they're overlooked, about how when things happen to them, people don't care. Just the whole homeless situation. And it's kind of put that all into a film that, you know, that just doesn't hit you over the head with the homeless issue, but it presents them in a thoughtful story. And I enjoyed CHUD. I thought CHUD was a very entertaining film. It has really, really decent characters. I really like Christopher Curry as Captain Bosch. He's my favorite character in the film. And even John Heard did a great job as the photographer. His girlfriend, nice-looking girl. She does appear almost nude in the film. And this film got an R rating, which it definitely deserved because there is gore in the film. Back in 1984, so it's all practical. But CHUD is a really, really entertaining film. I really like this movie. Really like what it had to say. Right now, it'd probably be considered a typical film with the government covering up certain events. And let's just say, guys, that in this movie, and I'm not even going to say that because I don't want to ruin it for you. I want you to go give it a look. But CHUD, I believe, is a highly entertaining horror film. It does have horror elements in it. Not to just too much emphasis on suspense and tension, but you know there are scenes where there is a decent amount of horror elements in it. And Daniel Stern does a really, really good job in the film as the head of the homeless shelter. Really quirky character. I liked him in the film. It really, in this movie, everybody's pretty likable all the way around except for the government agents, the people that are at the top of the cover-up. But overall, a decent cast. I enjoyed it. Really, really good monster effects for the time. I really liked the monster effects. Creatures looked really, really decent in my opinion. And I definitely got to wholeheartedly recommend CHUD. And if you do buy this, which this is on Amazon.com now, I believe, for around $10. But if you do buy this, definitely get the 96-minute edition and pass on the 88-minute. And this comes with a director's commentary as well, and has a few special features on it, guys. Nothing that are just going to blow you away, but I mean, you do have some. The biggest thing is the audio commentary, and it includes the director, the writer, and three of the stars of the film. And then you, of course, you get the theatrical trailer and a behind the scenes photo gallery. Not a whole lot, but definitely for a film like this, you know, you're lucky to get that because it film cost like $1.5 million to make it. It grossed like $4.5 million, which, you know, it did make a profit. But a film like this, you know, you're lucky to get any kind of special features on this. But definitely I got to recommend CHUD, guys. Check it out. I don't want to reveal too much, so, you know, you'll be you won't be spoiled when you see the film. But definitely check it out. CHUD. I definitely have to recommend it. Thanks for watching, everybody. Next up is the sequel, CHUD 2. Thanks.